which could have an impact between individuals. We also found that many times some armed personnel were behind these acts. Some people and some were obliged to respond to the opening of fire. In Idlib, for example, there was a new development. Not opening a fire. In Idlib, we saw that there were some strange operations, bombings, explosions, which targeted a lot of the institutions. Many institutions, and I'd like to say very clearly that this might not be accepted at all for the Arab community and for the whole world. Such acts are unacceptable. These bombings, they targeted civilian buses, military buses, the pipelines for oil, also trucks which transport diesel, some buildings, some also electric power stations. All of these were targeted by bombings. So in this particular case, there was no confrontation, but there were bombings. This happened in Idlib, as I said, and in Freyh. We also found that because we were present in some areas, there was a lot of exaggeration. And in many times these are lies. They make accusations against us and they try and mislead people about the work or the efforts being pursued by the mission. When it comes to the protesters actually, and the protests, we found the protests, of course, were being subject to attacks, maybe, or the security forces were attacking the protesters, were using arms against the protesters. After we came, we called on the leadership to stop this harming of protesters, stop the groups which are harming the protesters, to stay far away from the protest so that there will be no incitement or provocations between both sides. And so, as a result of this, the confrontations between the police and the security forces and the protesters this decreased, the confrontations between the protesters and the security services. Because many of the protesters, at some times they tried to of course continue with their efforts, they tried to take protection with the Arab League monitors, and hence these acts also decreased, the opening of fire or the harming of protesters. Now when it comes to the freeing of prisoners, we have pointed out to the fact that not many prisoners were freed. Of course, this is general information which you have. We know that around 20 prisoners were freed before. This is information we got from a lot of our sources. Some information spoke about 16, 18, some spoke about higher numbers. However, when we looked into this, we found that this information is incomplete. We need to verify this information. That they have repeated names. For example, they've mentioned the name of one prisoner released. They mentioned his name twice. There was also some confusion, so we weren't able to verify the exact number of prisoners who were freed. A lot of numbers were mentioned, high numbers, big numbers were mentioned, but as I said, we weren't able to verify this information about the number of prisoners. Some human rights organizations referred to some numbers, some opposition also referred to these numbers, and the Syrian leadership referred to different numbers of prisoners who were free. We found that the Syrian government told us that they freed 4,035 prisoners before the amnesty law was made. So this is information which we got from the Syrian leadership. This happened before the amnesty, meaning that the general number of those who were freed, and I actually got testimonies from some of the people who were freed, to about 2,300 or so who were freed by the military judiciary. Other information pointed out to 7,000. 7,100 according to the Syrian government. But there are 2,219 around this number who were freed over the past 2 days after this report was, or during the time when this report was being put together. We, as a mission, we have verified that over 3,000 prisoners were freed. Before the amnesty law, and after the amnesty law, we know that over 1,000 prisoners were freed. And the day before yesterday, I got some information as well from my sources that there are two groups of prisoners who were freed as well. When it comes to the media and how the media covers the situation, the Syrian government, it says it allowed many, over 100 media sources to come in. This is from the beginning of the event, not during the time of the Arab League presence. These numbers also say that 112 entered Syria, 112 media channels. Other sources say that there are 90 media sources who have representatives inside Syria. We looked into all of this, the coverage of the media. We found that there were 36 media outlets in Syria working inside the country. And so we also heard complaints from some of the local media or some media which entered into Syria. We heard complaints from foreign media. The foreign media complained that they were given a specific time only to cover the events. We spoke with the Syrian government about this, not to set a specific time for the media representatives. They again responded, Syrian government responded and said 10 days were given to the media representatives, and this 10-day period can be extended, is able to extension if the media representatives request. Of course, there were also a caution made that some foreign media not enter into the opposition. This forced some of the media to enter some areas together with the Arab League delegation, the delegation of observers, for their own safety. And we told the media outlets, we don't mind if you come with us, because we are, of course, looking what is going on, and we take responsibility for ourselves. And if you want to come with us, you also must take responsibility. The Arab League does not take responsibility for you. So they agreed, and many of the media came with us. The day before yesterday, for example, around 9 media outlets, representatives of the media, BBC, CNN, French news outlets, a group of media outlets, which included Syrian media as well, they came with us to some of the areas like Al-Zabadani, and thank God they lived through the experience, and no harm was done to them, thank God.
طيب ايضا
اوكي
بعض الوكالات
some of the news agencies
نحن طلبنا طبعا عملنا ويب سايت
We established, we announced that we had begun with a website. We announced this and the Arab League also had its own website which had announced regarding the monitors or the observers. It said that if there was any problem for any news agency or media source, then it must inform about this problem. It must speak to us about this problem so that the Syrian government can respond and express its complete readiness to give the right and give a license to any media source which wants to enter into Syria without any hesitation. We requested this of the Syrian government. However, ever since we entered into Syria, we received around five complaints or five requests, which can be considered complaints as well. And they entered, these five media outlets were able to enter into Syria. After that, we didn't receive any other complaints about preventing any media outlets from entering into Syria. Actually, I want to speak about I spoke about the sincerity and the credibility of the Arab League mission. I spoke about this to the Arab League. Of course, many people expressed doubts in the media about this Arab League mission, but I'd like to stress to you that we respect the media, we respect what the media says. However, sometimes the media is too harsh on us. We weren't affected by this. What concerns us is what is happening, what happened inside Syria, what we saw. We didn't make any assumptions, we didn't speak in an individual way, we didn't behave according to our own personal feelings. We behaved and we worked in accordance to what we saw and witnessed on the ground. So we submitted, we transferred the real picture on the ground to the Arab League leadership. I'd like to speak about what was said on Al Jazeera. They said that the head of the Arab League mission called for extending the period or the mandate of the mission. Of course, I don't have the right to do this. I make this request. If I have recommendations, this recommendation is regarding the equipment. In my recommendations, I said that if there is an intent, if there is an intention to extend the period, then this must mean we need more logistical support, more equipment. But I don't have the right to call for extending the period myself. And I stressed on providing the political and media support for the Arab League mission. This is in order to carry out our duty the best way. This is what I demanded. This is what I requested. I also stressed on a peaceful process because in the end of this must lead to a peaceful dialogue between the different sides. This is what the protocol states. I stressed on quickly going ahead with the national dialogue. At the same time, whereby the mission continues. So what I demanded is that not after we finish the national dialogue begins, because the presence of the Arab League together with the beginning of the national dialogue, this is a very good process which would lead to positive results on the ground and would achieve or would make achievements for the Arab League mission. This is what was requested, and I pray to God that we can send our message in the appropriate way. And in order for you